rate is proportional to the concentration of reactants raised by the power one are called as first order reaction. They are called first order reactions. Done. Understood? So the reactions for which rate is proportional to the concentration of reactants raised by the power one. So this is according to definition of which one? According to definition of rate law. Now what we should apply? Like as the previous derivation. According to definition of rate of reaction, rate is equal to minus dr by dt. This is the equation number 2. So comparing 1 and 2, from 1 and 2 what can we write? From 1 and 2, both are the equations of rate, so you could write K into R is equal to minus dr by dt. So now here it is K into dt is equal to minus 1 by R into dr. Now what we should do is integrating. So minus sign also we can bring this side. Integrating on both sides. What will happen when we integrate on both sides? Integral minus K into dt is equal to integral 1 by r dr. Now we have to apply the limits. It is a time limit is 0 to t, and it is a concentration limits are r naught to r. So k is a constant which we can take outside. So minus k into integral dt, it is t. Integral dt is t with limits. What are the limits here? 0 to t is equal to, here we have a formula, integral 1 by x dx is equal to natural logarithm ln x. Natural logarithm is the base e log x. This is the 1 by r dr, so it is like a logarithm of r. And limits, what are the limits here? That is r naught to r. So now upper limit minus k into upper limit minus lower limit, that is the t minus 0 is equal to, similarly same limits, log r minus log r naught, right. So now next one, so here minus kt is equal to log r, this minus sign we are taking this side, so minus, so it becomes log r naught minus log r. So kt is equal to log r naught divided by r. R naught divided by r is the base e. Now kt is equal to, it's a base e, we have to convert into base 10. How can we convert? By multiplying with 2.303. So now it is logarithm next base 10 log r naught by r. It is a base 10. Now k, we have to find expression of k. K is equal to 2.303 by t log r naught divided by r. This is the final answer. To find the rate constant of first order reaction. First order reaction, where again you can write r naught is, what is the r naught here? Initial concentration of reactant. Initial concentration of reactant. And r, that is final concentration of reactants, final concentration of reactants after time t, and t is time taken for reaction, and k, you know, k is first order rate constant. This is the expression for first order reaction. It's a very easy thing. We need to do two things. One is we have to apply the definition of rate law. Second, we have to apply the definition of rate of reaction. Both are rate, so you can equate, and if after equating, then we apply integrating. Integration limits, time limit 0 t, concentration limits r naught to r, and we get the value. But the same formula we can also express in pressure also. The same formula we can explain in terms of pressure. There are some numericals based on pressure. So pressure, what can we write? K is equal to 2.303 by T log P naught by P. What is P naught? What is the P naught? Initial pressure of reactant, and P is the final pressure of reactant. You can apply in terms of concentration, you can apply in terms of pressure also, both are same. So it is the first order. And we have to see three things. One is example, then graph, then half-life. Then first order topic will be over. Take notes. Right. So now examples. So now three things we should see. First is example. Three things. Point number one. Example, it is decomposition of ammonia. Decomposition of ammonia at low concentration or low pressure. So NH3, it is a 2NH3. On platinum surface, it decomposed to give N2 plus 3H2. Here, actually, there is a big reasoning question behind this. So, if you want, I'll tell you that. Actually, the rate of reaction for this is given as K into NH3. K1 into NH3 divided by 1 plus K2 into NH3. This is the expression, experimental one, not need to know how it has come. Now case one, if concentration of NH3 is less, is very very less than 1, concentration of NH3 is less than 1, so here this term can be ignored, this k2 term can be ignored, so that in that case rate is equal to k1 into concentration of NH3. So which means what is the order of reaction now? That is, order of reaction is 1. If concentration of NH3 is, if concentration of NH3 is very very greater than 1, then here 1 can be ignored, then rate is equal to k1 into NH3 divided by k2 into NH3. So NH3, NH3 cancelled out, so therefore rate is equal to k1 by k2. What is the order? K1 by k2 into NH3 power, it is 0. So what is the order now? It is 0 order, it is the first order. So it means when concentration of NH3 is low, then it is first order, and when concentration of NH3 is high, this is 0 order. So there is a big concept behind all this. If you are able to understand, no doubt, otherwise late, no problem. So decomposition of NH3 at low concentration, this is first order. Second example, very very important, you have to remember it. That is, all zero or all what you can say, radioactive reactions, all radioactive reactions means radiation emitting reaction like uranium, thorium, radium, carbon 14. So they all are called radioactive reactions. All radioactive reactions belong to first order. Third example is decomposition of N2O5. It is also first order reaction. So it's a 2N2O5. It gives 2N2O4 plus O2. So these are the three examples for first order reaction. Now, number two, graph. We have to derive or we have to deduce graph. What is the formula for first order rate constant? Just now we have derived it. K is equal to 2.303 by T log R naught divided by R. Log R naught divided by R. This we will do in Y is equal to MX plus C form. So what can we write here? KT divided by 2.303 is equal to log of A by B. So log A, that is log R naught minus log R. Log R naught minus log R. So here log R we will make a subject. Log R is equal to log R naught. Log R naught minus K by 2.303 into T. Now it is looking as Y is equal to C plus MX. Now graph, we have to draw graph. On Y axis what we should take? Log concentration. Last time in zero order we have taken only concentration. So this is log concentration. On X axis, that is time T. Slope is negative slope, so the graph will come like this, where slope is equal to minus K divided by 2.303, minus K divided by 2.303, and here the intercept value is log R naught. So in questions they ask the graph, they just give you the graph and ask you to identify the order. If the graph of log R versus time, it is the first order. If it is simply R versus time, then it is zero order. And one more thing, the graph which we have drawn in the log R, if they ask in examination, it is ln R. What is the slope of the graph when we draw ln R versus time? In that case, the slope will be only minus k. Only minus k. 2.303 will not come. So remember that. If you have log r, then slope is minus k by 2.303. If you have ln r, then slope will be minus k. So two things are over. One is example. Second one is graph. One more thing we have to find. What is the another thing? You all know. That is half life period. T half. Yes. This is the unnecessary one, so I am erasing it. If you want, you can note down. No problem. So now third point. Third point is half life period. Half life period. This is T half. T half. What do you mean by half life period? Yes, it is the time taken to reduce the concentration, initial concentration into half of, I mean final concentration. Here, final concentration R will equal to initial half of the initial value, R naught divided by 2. Final concentration R is equal to R naught by 2 when time T is equal to T half. This condition we have to put in first order rate constant. K is equal to 2.303 by T log R naught divided by R. So put that condition here. So K is equal to 2.303 by T half log R naught divided by 2. So R naught cancel. So now K is equal to 2.303 by T half into log 2. So K is equal to 2.303 into 0.3010 divided by T half. So T half is equal to 0.693 divided by K. This is the formula for first order rate constant. This is the formula for first order rate constant. And here T half is independent on R naught initial concentration. Means what? Here let us take 100 gram, convert into 50 gram in, let us assume 1 hour time. This is the T half. Now 50 gram convert into 25 gram in same 1 hour time. Here R naught, this is the R naught value and this is the T half value. So here T half value does not change with initial concentration, not like as the previous case. In the previous case it was changing in zero order, it is not like this. Here even 2 gram convert into 1 gram, it also needs 1 hour time. It also needs 1 hour. So it means T half, R naught, whatever it is, the T half remains constant. This is half life period of first order reaction. So first order reaction is over. Examples, graph, half life period. So second order is not in syllabus, third order is not in syllabus. So we have only two things in syllabus. One is zero order and another one is first order. We have finished both. So now numericals we have to see. We will see numericals. Take notes. So now exercise question. exercise questions. So let us see some exercise questions. So in the previous class, we have done question number 9. 10, 11, 12, I will explain afterwards. Question number 13 is a very easy question. You can do by yourself also. Question number 13. See. Calculate the half-life of first order reaction from the rate constant given. So they said it is a first order reaction. And we have to find half-life. So what is the formula for first order reaction half-life? Just now we have derived d half is equal to 0.693 by k. So in first question, k is equal to 200 second inverse. So t half is equal to what? T half is equal to 0.693 by 200. Let it be in seconds, no problem. And second, k is equal to 2 minute inverse. Let it be in minutes, need not to change. So t half is equal to 0.693 by 2 minutes. And third, 4k is equal to 4 year inverse. So t half is equal to 0.693 by 4. Its unit will be years. No problem. This is the question number 13. So I hope you understood it. It's a very easy question. Now question number 14. The half-life of radioactive decay of 14C is 5730 years. Means T half. It is 5730 years. And they use the word radioactive decay. Radioactive decay means immediately we should understand this is first order reaction. All radioactive reactions are first order reaction. An archaeological artifact contained wood had only 80% of the C14 found in the living tree. Means one artifact, archaeological artifact means one old piece, means ek ped mein tukda jo hai, lakdi mila hai, jisme 80% C14 hai. It means let the initial concentration is R0 is equal to X. Then final concentration R is equal to 80% of initial value. Means 0.8X. Now estimate the age of the sample. Age of sample means time T is question mark. You tell me, how can you do this? I have written the information. So we know that they said it is first order reaction. We know that k is equal to 2.303 by t log r naught by r. But k value is not given. What can we do? So instead of k, they have given t half. So k ki jagah pe kya likh sakte? 0.693 by t half is equal to 2.303 by t log r naught by r. So can we write like this? So here t half is given. So 0.693 divided by 5730. Let it be in years. No problem. So time will also come in years. So answer whatever you are going to write, that is in years only. 2.303 by t log r naught is x divided by 0.8x. So simplify it, you will get answer that the time t in the unit years, because t half was in years, so t will also be in years. Understood this? T half is given. They said radioactive, which means first order reaction. R naught, let us say x. R is 0.8x. Age of the sample means time t we have to find from this equation. Right. So two questions are over. Take the notes. Next, question number 16, same type question. So accordingly you can solve. See, the question is question number 16, then 17, 18, 19. These questions you can solve by yourself, so there won't be any problem. Even question number 25 also. But I will just give you hints. Question number 16. See, question number 16. The rate constant of a first order reaction, rate constant means K, is equal to 60 second inverse. It is said first order reaction. How much time will it take to reduce its initial concentration of reactant to 1/16th value? So time t is question mark. Let initial concentration, r naught, let us say this value is x, then final concentration, r is 1/16th. They said it is 1/16th of x, so it means 1/16 of x. It is said which order? First order. Even though it is given in question, no problem. And from the units also you can recognize. These units specify that it is a first order reaction. It is a first order reaction. So now K is equal to 2.303 by T log R naught by R. So here K is given to you 60. So 2.303 by t, time t, log r naught we are taking as x, it is x by 16. This is x by 16. Simplify this and you will get the answer. Time t in the unit. What will be the unit? K is in second inverse, so t will be in the unit of seconds. T will be in the unit of seconds. That's question number 16. So question number 17, I'll just give you hints. During a nuclear explosion, one of the product is strontium 90 with half-life period. T half of strontium is 28.1 years. If 1 microgram of strontium was absorbed in the bones of newly born baby, initial concentration, how much strontium is absorbed in the bones? 1 microgram. Let it be in microgram, no problem. How much of it will remain after 10 years and 60 years if it was not lost metabolically? Case 1. So we have to find after 10 years. Means this is going to be time t. T and t half both are in the same unit. So what is the final concentration R? That is question mark. How can we get? So it's a first order reaction because it is a radioactive reaction. Strontium is a radioactive. So radioactive means first order reaction. So So k is equal to 2.303 by t log r naught by r. But here k is not given. Then how can we do? So instead of k, t half is given. So in, k means 0.693 by t half is equal to 2.303 by t log r naught by r. So here t half is given to you, t is given to you, r naught is given to you. You have to find r. So find the final concentration of r, whatever it is. It will come in the units of micrograms. It will be in micrograms, no problem. That's the case one. Now case two. Same thing. After 60 years, which is the time t. So we have to find the final concentration r. Final concentration r is question mark. So same way we can follow and you will get final concentration r value. So this is question number 17. Understood? 16 and 17 questions. 18th also you can do, 19th also you can do. So do it by yourself. The remaining questions I will explain in the next class. Done? So take note. So these questions you have to practice, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 25.
Thank you.